So what is COMSOL Multiphysics? To start with, COMSOL Multiphysics is a simulation software. To specify, it is a software used for mathematical modeling in physics and engineering. Now, inside of COMSOL Multiphysics software, you have the option to design your model, to add physics properties, to mesh and simulate, and also to view the simulation result. This is a complete package, and that makes the software unique. Now let me explain a typical simulation workflow. First step is to set up your objective, which you want to simulate. The second step is to design your geometry, which you might want to simulate in the software. Then you apply proper boundary condition in your model, and then you set up the different parameters such as time, dimension, etc. And then you run the simulation and analyze your results. This is generally a typical workflow for simple simulations. So this is a typical window in a COMSOL Multiphysics software. So let me just briefly tell you how the software actually works. So in the model builder section, you will have list of all the options that are present in your model. So currently this is an empty document, so nothing is present. For example, if I want to create a 3D component, the 3D component will be added. Similarly, if I add a geometry, that is a block, and click on build all object, I will have my block here, and you will see the block is also shown inside the model builder. So the model builder actually shows all the settings and steps that are present in the model. In the top, you have all the settings. Just like Microsoft Word and Excel, you have different sections and you have different settings. Depending on the type of simulation you are doing, you have to use that accordingly. And in the center, you have the settings and properties tab. Generally, properties are hardly used, or at least I don't use actually. So the main setting is the settings tab. So how it works is, whenever you select a setting, let's say I select mesh, inside of settings you have all the options that you need to change. So when I click on block, you will see that I have the size and shape section, position, axis type, and all the settings. So the center region is the settings section in the software. And if you come to the right, you have the graphics tab. So inside the graphics, you have all the visual information of your model. It could be your results, it could be your graphs, it could be the material window. For example, if I click on mesh, you have the mesh object here in the graphics. Or let's say when you click on add materials or add study, or simply if you click on add physics, you have all the different physics here in the right section. Of course, you can drag the tab to some other location, but it is not advisable. The default location is fine. Now in the bottom section, you have the information, that is the logs and other vital information you need for your simulation. For example, if you have a table, it will show up here. It messages, for example, I created a geometry that has one domain, six boundaries, 12 edges. All this information are shown in the message section. Similarly, when you are running a simulation, the progress section will show what percentage of your simulation is completed, the convergence data, etc. In the log section, you have all the logs, that is, I created the mesh, so it is showing me the mesh details, etc. So this is how the software works. I hope it gave you some idea if you are starting out in COMSOL. If you are totally new, you can check out my basic course in COMSOL. It will be linked in the description. And you can consider subscribing to my channel to support me and also follow similar videos.